series of the African Cup of Nations commence tomorrow with Nigeria taking on Cameroon as the action-packed Australian Open gradually reaches its crescendo. And in Europe, Africa Cup matches take center stage in England, but Italy, Spain and Germany focus on the league. Good morning and welcome to another exciting edition of Sport Trip. I am Olujimi Dare-Ogun saying welcome to the show. And so we begin with Formula One, where Ferrari driver Charles Leclerc says he is pleased to extend his contract with the team for several more seasons to come. His 26-year-old made his Formula One debut with Sauber before signing a 5-year contract after an impressive first season with the team in 2019. Monegasque Leclerc finished 5th in the Drivers' Championship last season. Continuing, he says, "To race for this team has always been my dream ever since I was 3 years old. I used to watch Monaco Grand Prix from the window of a friend's apartment at Saint-Devoir Corner, and I will always look out for the red cars. The team is my second family ever since I joined the Ferrari Driver Academy in 2016, and I've achieved a lot together, fighting through thick and thin over the past 5 years. However, I believe my best is yet to come, and I can't wait for this season to start to make further progress and be competitive at every race. My dream remains that of winning the World Championship with Ferrari." End of quote. Ferrari has not specified the length of Leclerc's new contract. His previous one ran until the end of 2024, and the new one is said to be a further 5 year, running until 2029. His salary has been reported to rise from his current 25 million euros a year to 50 million euros by the end of the contract. And now to tennis. Tennis great Martina Navratilova and Chris Evert says hosting the WTA finals in Saudi Arabia will be a step backward for women's tennis. The WTA came close to staging the 2023 finals in Saudi before going to Cancun in Mexico. However, the WTA is considering moving the season-ending event to Riyadh for future tournaments. Navratilova and Evert said this would represent not progress but significant regression for the sport. In an opinion piece for Washington Post, the pair who dominated women's tennis during the 1970s and 80s described the WTA finals as the crown jewel of women's tour. They criticized the WTA board for not consulting players about the potential move and asked the governing body to start an open, honest discussion to question whether progress and engagement is really possible in the Gulf state. Saudi Arabia has been accused of using the event to sport wash its reputation. The state's reputation of human rights violation and oppressing women has come under intense international scrutiny, and boxing, Formula One and golf have all been criticized for holding events in the country in recent years. And now to the down under. Aryna Sabalenka remained on track to defend the Australian Open crown after reaching the Melbourne final by avenging her loss to Coco Gauff in last year's US Open showpiece. Belarusian second seed Sabalenka won 7-6-6-4 against American four seed Gauff in a 10 semi-final. Brits were edging in an error-free first set with 6 breaks before Sabalenka pounced defensively late in the second. The 25-year-old Belarusian is the first woman to reach back-to-back finals since Serena in 2017.
I think I was able to focus on myself and kind of like I was prepared that she's going to move really good and she's going to put all balls back to me, and I just have to be ready to play an extra shot, and I was just ready for anything tonight, and I think that was the key, and definitely your support, guys. Last time I played her, I didn't have, I would say, almost any support, and today, guys, thank you. All the support for the atmosphere, you make this place really special for me. Thank you.
Sabalenka will face Chinese 12 seed Zheng Quan in Saturday's final. Zheng reached her first Grand Slam showpiece by ending Ukrainian qualifier Daria Yastrebska's incredible run with a 6-4-6-4 win in Thursday's second semi-final. Zheng is aiming to become the second Chinese woman to win the Australian Open singles title on the 10th anniversary of the last famous victory. And now to football. On the home scene, Remo Stars goalkeeper Kayode Bankole is convinced that his team have all it takes to win the 2023-2024 Nigerian Premier Football League title. Bankole believes it will be a disappointing NPFL campaign without the title. Remo Stars currently occupy the second position on the NPFL table with 35 points. Quoting him, he says, "We can feel the NPFL at Remo this season. This is our time to lift the trophy. It will be a huge blow to finish with nothing. We truly believe I will do everything we can to grab maximum points in as many games as we can and have a fantastic season. I truly believe we can do it. Lobby Stars are a top team, but there are a lot of other top teams in this division who can challenge for the title. There are plenty of others, but we can be very positive and achieve good things this season. We can win titles because of the environment we have here and the quality of players at our disposal." Football legend Paulo Palermo has named Chelsea, Manchester City, Manchester United and Liverpool as the four clubs that can afford Super Eagles striker Victor Osimhen. Osimhen's future at Napoli has been another talking point amid the ongoing January transfer window. The 25-year-old recently loses a possibility of leaving Napoli this month, but is open to the idea at the end of the current season. Osimhen, who is currently on international duty with Nigeria at the ongoing 2023 African Cup of Nations, has been linked with several clubs in Europe, including Real Madrid, Paris Saint-Germain and Chelsea. Speaking on the future of Osimhen, Palermo said, and I quote, "I have said since he renewed that he's leaving, extending his contract for just 1 year means having already sold him. Otherwise, they will renew his contract for 4 years. I think someone has already joined. I think Chelsea. Those who can spend 120 to 130 million euros at Chelsea, City, United and Liverpool. I don't think Arsenal, Tottenham could do it, but they have a salary cap of 6 to 7 million euros. Osimhen already earns 10 million euros. Two-day break, the African Cup of Nations resumed with the knockout stage. Angola on Saturday will take on Namibia before the Super Eagles of Nigeria take on Cameroon later in the day. On Sunday is the battle of the Guineans between Equatorial Guinea and Guinea, and Egypt's seven-time champions will take on DR Congo. And now to the camp of the Super Eagles. Former Democratic Republic of Congo defender Gabriel Zoukwani has backed Victor Osimhen to have the Super Eagles team victory against Cameroon. The Super Eagles and Indomitable Lions will clash in what is expected to be a thrilling encounter at the Felix Oboibodine Stadium in Abidjan on Saturday. It will be the first meeting between both teams since the Super Eagles knocked out their perennial rivals in the round of 16 at AFCON 2019 finals in Egypt. Osimhen has struggled a bit in Cote d'Ivoire, registering one goal in three appearances. Zoukwani, who is currently the assistant manager of DR Congo under 20, believe this is the right time for the Nigeria hitman to prove his mettle in the competition. Quoting him, he says, "Nigeria against Cameroon stand out for me. They actually hit each other. It will be great to see some challenges flying in that one, just to see Osimhen if he starts producing the goals. He is getting the chances, but not the goals. I would like to see him light up that one because he's looking forward to that one." Meanwhile, the Indomitable Lions of Cameroon have arrived in Abidjan ahead of Saturday's round of 16 encounter against the Super Eagles of Nigeria. The former African champions, Robert Song's side, jetted into Abidjan from Bokeh on Thursday night. The former African champions were based in Yamoussoukro for the opening two games against Guinea and Senegal. They will trade at the Stade Municipal de Bougainville on Friday. Cameroon finished in second place in Group C behind title holder Teranga Lions of Senegal. And now to football. In Europe yesterday in the Copa del Rey quarterfinal, Atletico Madrid defeated Sevilla by 1-0, despite Antoine Griezmann missing a penalty. In England, FA Cup fixtures ran first kick start yesterday, with Bournemouth defeating Swansea by 5-0. Later today is Chelsea against Aston Villa, Tottenham against Manchester City. Another big fixtures coming up this weekend is Leicester City against Birmingham, Fulham against Newcastle, not forgetting Newport County against Manchester United. The Spanish La Liga this weekend is Real Sociedad against Rayo Vallecano, Las Palmas against Real Madrid, Barcelona against Villarreal, not forgetting Mallorca against Real Betis. Cadiz will play against Athletic Club, while Atletico Madrid will play against Valencia. In the Italian Serie A, it's Cagliari against Torino today, Juventus Empoli, AC Milan against Bologna tomorrow, Lazio will play Napoli on Sunday, not forgetting Fiorentina against Inter Milan. Finally, in the German Bundesliga, Augsburg will welcome Bayern Munich, Werder Bremen against Freiburg, not forgetting Wolfsburg against Cologne. Bayer Leverkusen at home will play against Borussia Mönchengladbach. Later on Sunday, it's Borussia Dortmund against Bochum, not forgetting Union Berlin against Darmstadt. This is where we call it a wrap on today's edition of Spot Trip. Keep listening to us on Lagos Traffic Radio 96.1. I am Olujimi Dare-Ogun, saying stay sporty, stay healthy.
For me, 2012.